What's going on, guys? This is Sam. I'm so tired of talking about iOS 11.4.1, but here we are. We have Beta 5 that just came out today, and there's nothing that changed again. This still is not the Golden Master version either. So as you can see, there's still that little A down there at the bottom, which means that this isn't the Golden Master. Every once in a while, Apple won't remove the letter at the end and then just release the public version anyway. But officially, this doesn't look like it is the final version of iOS 11.4.1 yet, which means that we'll probably be seeing another beta in the future. It was a pretty small update, I think around 30 or 40 megabytes here on the iPhone 8, and nothing changing here. Once again, the only new feature in this update is under Touch ID and passcode, or Face ID and passcode settings for USB accessories. If you turn that on, it will allow access to USB accessories after your device has been locked for more than 1 hour. But with that disabled, you are the most secure, so that USB accessories cannot tamper with your device, like the gray key law enforcement tool that allows you to brute force iPhone passcodes that helps to circumvent that. Even though this release is not the Golden Master version, I did run a Geekbench test, and the scores were actually the highest that I've ever gotten on iOS 11.4.1 so far. So I guess you could count this as the one major change or feature in this update, but still nothing you'll really notice. 4214 for the single core score, 10,251 for the multi-core score, a lot better than on Beta 4, 4188 versus 10,171. You can see every single time they are going up just a little bit, which is a really good sign. That means that Apple's probably putting a lot of work in the background to make sure that iOS 11.4.1 is going to be incredible when it launches. Incredible stability and performance wise, it's crazy that iOS 12 is faster than iOS 11.4.1 already, but this should be a good place for Apple to wrap up the iOS 11 release cycle. I feel like Apple has to release this later this month. If we look back at iOS 10.3.3 last year, Apple released that in the middle of July, and I could see the exact same thing happening this year. There's not a lot happening here. There's no reason that Apple would have to delay this. This update is probably right around the corner, and rightfully so, because it's so small. So that's iOS 11.4.1 Beta 5. We've had a long time in beta testing so far. The stability seems to be improving over time. And battery life, I honestly couldn't give you a good opinion on, just because I haven't been using this device as my daily driver. In the past, it's felt like it's better than iOS 11.4, and hopefully it corrects the battery life drain issues that I know a lot of people are experiencing on iOS 11.4. But for now, that's all I've got to say about iOS 11.4.1 Beta 5. So if you enjoyed watching, if you learned something new, make sure to drop a like down below. And of course, hit subscribe for more videos like this in the future. If you want to go that extra mile to help support the channel, you can head over to shop.iupdateos.com, and that would be incredible. For now, I've been Sam. I hope all of you are doing great, and I will talk to you in my next video.